So, predictive processing and active inference. Your brain is a model of your body in the world. And what that means is, the model, it is a bunch of predictions, which is basically your beliefs about what the world is and what you are in the world. It's the model is the sum total of all your beliefs about what the world is and yourself in the world. Let me give you an example of that in real life. I have a friend who is working on increasing the number of push-ups she can do. So there's this thing about this friend of mine, about her model. She quits when things get hard. That's what she's working against. It's too hard. Once I get to number 8, I just quit when it gets too hard. That's my belief about hard things. I just quit. That's a really important piece of this. She told me one of the ways that she used this understanding to help herself in her quest to do more push-ups. She can do 10 push-ups, and she's been practicing doing 10 push-ups. She gets to the 8th push-up, and she's like, I just don't want to do this. And she kind of likes to give up. She kind of likes to be like, I can't do that many. All this stuff she's been hearing from me about predictive processing and this model and these beliefs that we have, she put it together in her mind that she could, because one of the things about these beliefs is that we have simulations, which are also called predictions. Anyway, we can simulate what we believe to be true in the world. What she decided at that 8th push-up, she did something kind of magical that can be done when you understand that this model is a bunch of beliefs. And she said, these next 2 push-ups are gonna feel like the first 2 push-ups I did. I'm gonna have the same amount of energy, the same power as I had for the first 2 push-ups. She changed the firing of her own sensory and motor neurons in her brain. And literally, those last 2 push-ups felt to her like the first 2 push-ups that she had done. So in changing the belief that the last 2 push-ups were gonna be so hard into the experience that they were gonna be as easy as the first 2, they were. And that is the power of this predictive brain, this model, this belief that you carry around with you. You will find that your body actually has more resources in it than the general belief that you carry around with you says that you have. And this is known in physiology to actually be true. So that's today's nugget about the predictive brain. See you next time.